First of all, there's capability-based planning. Perhaps this is the source of the most requested new concept in ArchiMate. I think over the last 5 years or so, capability-based planning has seen increased usage, and especially the last 3 years, I've seen a lot of organizations drawing up capability maps and working with capabilities as a way of planning investments and also to identify things they lack. So that's resulted in these four new concepts that we've added to the language that really help you address this, say, more strategic planning issue. First of all, there's capability. And I'm not going to repeat all the definitions to you, but it's just to give you a flavor of what these things mean. And capability is what you can do as an organization, what you're able to do. So it's something that you may be able to do right now. It could also be something you want to be able to do in the future. And that's, of course, what you want to do with capability-based planning. You want to identify the capabilities that you need to develop, that you need to improve, or that you want to acquire. In that sense, it's also a concept that's different from a business function. We can have a long discussion on the difference between capability and function, but business functions are more closely aligned to the current organization structure, are explicitly managed by the organization and assigned to organization units that have to perform these functions. But capabilities are more future-oriented, are more aimed at what you want to be able to do and where you want to go with the organization. And capabilities are often not explicitly managed. You might have all kinds of abilities as an organization that you don't explicitly assign responsibilities to. So it could be that you uncover new capabilities that you already have but didn't realize, and you can do new things with that, maybe create new business out of that. So capabilities and business functions are related, but they're not the same. You do need business functions to realize your capabilities, but capabilities can be much broader than that. We'll see some examples later on. Then we have resource. Resource is a generic concept that collects all the, let's say, all the structure elements in ArchiMate that contribute to the capability. So those could be the people in the organization, the systems you have, the physical assets, but also the skills, etc. Those can all be seen as resources. Financial resources, of course. Those all help you realize these capabilities. And then we have a new concept called outcome. We did have concepts for modeling goals, but we didn't have concepts for modeling the results. So we now have a concept called outcome that helps you model what you actually achieve. And finally, course of action, that's a new concept that I mentioned already that was taken from the business motivation model. It's typically used to model strategies and tactics. So it's typically used to describe how you employ certain capabilities to achieve these outcomes you want to have. So capabilities are typically used in the form of a capability map. That's the most common way of drawing that. It's a structured overview of what the organization does or can do. And it's very useful to use capability maps because you can map all kinds of other information onto them. Say the strategic importance of certain capabilities, or the cost associated with them, or performance or other KPIs. You can relate all kinds of resources to them. And you can, of course, use it for planning purposes. So the example I'm using today is from Arc Insurance, our fictitious but realistic insurance company that we have used for many years now. There's this description in the white paper available through the open group on Arc Insurance and SOGAP. This is also something we're now updating to reflect the ArchiMate 3 concept. But this is the Arc Insurance capability map, inspired by the Panorama 360 reference model for insurance companies. So here you see the typical things that Arc Insurance needs to be able to do to function as an insurance company. This is their current capability map, divided in strategic, operational, and supporting capabilities. This is what they do today. And then they've made an assessment of their current capabilities against efficiency. So they've created a number of metrics to see how efficient their capabilities are, benchmark them against an industry average, and here you see the heat map resulting from that. And you see that some of these capabilities perform really well, the green ones, these are above average, but some perform below average, and there's room for improvement there. So this kind of depiction heat map like this, that's something that management often uses to see where they need to invest, where do we need to improve, where do we need to put management attention, etc. So this is just one such overview. Of course, there's more behind this. It's not just one number for a capability, but there can be a quite complicated analysis behind that. And I'll get to that later on. But these color maps, those are very useful. You can use them in various different ways. You can, well, for example, plot the strategic relevance of capabilities there. One strategy here is mapped in yellow and the other in orange. So some capabilities contribute to one strategy, others contribute to another strategy. You can use it to look at more detailed business goals. So here you see a bit more variation. And you can even plot, for example, the supporting applications on top of your capabilities. So this is, you get these striped pajama-like pictures. But this is really useful to show the same background, the same capability map, and map different kinds of information on top of that, because people recognize this layout, recognize the capabilities, and it's very easy to use this to depict all kinds of information. In our software BiZZdesign Enterprise Studio, this is really a one-click operation. It's really very easy to map that on top of these capabilities. So these color views are, I really use them very extensively to show all kinds of data. Like I said, there's more behind that than just the overview of capabilities and the colorful pictures. Capabilities are often assessed across different dimensions. And here I've taken six dimensions that are quite common: the people, process, and product dimensions, the technology supporting a capability, the information you have, and also an external vision on the capability. And here what you see is that the current state of the capability, well, it was a state in 2015, it lacks, especially in the product dimension. So there's a lot of room for improvement there. And this might also be a way to assign, to allocate investments to this capability specifically for this product dimension. It needs to improve in that dimension, so you can use these analyses to allocate your investments. To model this, of course, there's even more detail behind that. So what we see here is that this process dimension itself is, again, a more complicated metric that's built up from a number of different submetrics, in this case the adaptability, the maturity, the performance, and the variance of the process. We model that using so-called metrics. And in ArchiMate, in the language, there's a so-called language customization mechanism that's described in the standard, and it basically says that you can specialize existing concepts in the language and add these specializations to your models. And metric is one example of that. It's defined as a specialization of the already existing driver concept in ArchiMate, and a driver that can be measured. So a metric is a driver where you can really put a measure on it. And here I've got another one, a performance metric that has number of incidents, user experience, and SLA compliance as part of the metrics. And you see some numbers there. Those are the weights attached to that. Metrics are typically, on the one hand, associated to architecture elements. You measure something in the architecture element. And the outcome of the measurement, you can model that with the assessment concept in ArchiMate. So the metric tells you how to measure things. The assessment is then the outcome. So this is already supported by ArchiMate just by adding this one extension, this one concept. And then you can do things like this. If we then look at different capabilities of Arc Assurance and relate that to different strategic options, and I've listed there two options here, there's a longer story behind that, but we will show that in some of the blogs I'm currently writing. Arc Assurance sees two main strategic options. One is to really focus on cost savings and operational excellence and efficiency, and the other is to really focus on the customer and on becoming a fully digital insurance company, and they call that the digital customer intimacy strategy. So those are two different options, but you might even want to combine them. You might want to say, well, we have to be both efficient and very customer-oriented and focus on social media and some other things I'll explain later on. This is just a way of depicting these capabilities.